Hi everyone, today in this video let us discuss about the amphetamine, how this drug acts as an indirectly acting sympathomimetic. Amphetamine is one of the drugs which acts as a CNS stimulant, and this drug can be used in the two conditions. Particularly, it can be used in the treatment of ADHD, Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder. So this is one of the conditions observed in the children where they are having hyperactivity with lack of attention. In such condition, amphetamine can be given. But interestingly, amphetamine is a CNS stimulant which increases the hyperactivity. So use of amphetamine in this condition is a paradoxical use. This drug, even it produces hyperactivity, but it can reduce the hyperactivity disorders like the ADHD. So this is one of the clinical indication of amphetamine, as well as this drug can also be used in the treatment of narcolepsy. Narcolepsy is a condition of sudden attack of the sleep during the daytime. In such conditions, again, amphetamine acts as a CNS stimulant which increases the wakefulness, thereby it reduces the narcolepsy. So these are the two important clinical indications of the amphetamine. But apart from these two clinical indications, this drug can produce so many types of central as well as peripheral actions. And all these actions are mainly attributed to action of amphetamine on sympathetic system. So today let us see how this drug increases the sympathetic stimulation. What is the structure? First of all, it is the structure of amphetamine because it acts as a sympathomimetic. So this is the structure of amphetamine. And here you can observe it is not a catecholamine. It is not having OH groups attached to the phenyl ring system. But if we see the catecholamine, so this is the norepinephrine. You can observe here it is having the two OH groups which are attached to the phenyl ring system, as well as it is also having one OH group at the beta position to the amine. So these three OH groups are not present in the amphetamine. And lack of these OH groups may result in the indirect activity. And we can also observe another CH3 group here in the amphetamine which is not present in the norepinephrine. So these are the structural changes in the amphetamine which results in the indirect action on the sympathetic neurons. Ionization of the amphetamine. Already we have seen the structure of amphetamine and which is having a primary amine. So in the acidic environment, protons can attack this amine such that this amphetamine can be converted to ionized form. So now here this is having the NH3+, that is a quaternary ammonium group. Now this amphetamine is ionized. And when it is ionized, this drug is less absorbed through the GI tract. Otherwise, when it is ionized, it is more soluble in the aqueous environment, so it can be easily excreted within the urine. In this way, the pH at the GI tract as well as at the renal tubules can influence the bioavailability of the amphetamine. Particularly the acidifying drugs, like few other drugs like guanethidine, which is a noradrenergic neuron blocker, which can produce acidic pH within the GI environment. Similarly, urinary acidifiers can also increase the pH. Thereby, they can increase the excretion of the amphetamine. In this way, the bioavailability of amphetamine can be influenced by acidifying drugs. Now, let us see how this amphetamine acts. At the sympathetic neurons, which are present both at the periphery as well as within the CNS, one of the important mediators is the norepinephrine. This norepinephrine is going to be stored into the storage vesicles. And on the postsynaptic membrane, few of the receptors are present. There may be alpha receptors or beta receptors based on the location. Now, when the calcium enters into the presynaptic neurons, the presynaptic neuron is going to be depolarized. This can stimulate the release of the norepinephrine, where the norepinephrine can be released from the storage vesicles by exocytosis. And the released norepinephrine can act on either alpha receptors or it can act on the beta receptors. In this way, an action potential can only release the norepinephrine from the storage vesicles, which can act on the postsynaptic receptors. So this results in a direct sympathetic stimulation through the norepinephrine. But here amphetamine is not acting by this mechanism. This amphetamine mainly acts on one of the transporter NAT, norepinephrine transporter. Through this NAT, amphetamine can enter into the presynaptic neurons. And once it is present in the presynaptic neurons, it can act on the storage vesicles to displace the norepinephrine from the storage vesicles. In this way, amphetamine releases the norepinephrine from the storage vesicles, which is present within the cytoplasm of the presynaptic neurons. This free norepinephrine can be metabolized by the MAO enzyme within the cytoplasm, but here this norepinephrine can be exchanged through the same transporter for the exchange of one more molecule of the amphetamine. In this way, amphetamine is going to enter into the presynaptic nerve terminal and norepinephrine is going out of the nerve terminal into the synaptic cleft, As the amphetamine molecules are going to be accumulated within the presynaptic nerve terminal, more amount of the norepinephrine is going to be released into the synaptic cleft, which can act on either beta receptors or alpha receptors to produce the pharmacological action. That's why amphetamine can show the sympathetic activation irrespective of the presynaptic neuronal excitation, and it is not directly binding to the alpha or beta receptors, but it increases the binding of norepinephrine to these alpha or beta receptors by displacing from the storage vesicles. In this way, amphetamine acts in an indirect way. That's why it is called as indirectly acting sympathomimetic. What are the pharmacological actions? This drug mainly acts as a CNS stimulant, so the main pharmacological action is on the CNS. So one of the important effects on the CNS is the headache by cerebral vasodilatation, as well as dizziness can be observed. And because of the CNS stimulation, restlessness and agitation can be observed. And euphoria is one of the important effects of this amphetamine, which may result in the addiction problem. That's why amphetamine derivatives can act as drugs of abuse because of this euphoria. Tremors can also be observed because of the stimulation of CNS, and dyskinesia, some disturbance in the kinetic movements can also be observed. And at a high dose, the amphetamine can produce the excessive CNS stimulation, which may result in the precipitation of seizures in the patients, as well as some psychotic symptoms can also be observed in the patients. So at the therapeutic dose, it produces a mild CNS stimulation, but at a toxic dose, it can produce the seizures, psychosis, insomnia, and other central disorders. Similarly, on the CVS, cardiovascular system. Now, already we have seen that amphetamine is acting like an indirectly acting sympathomimetic. So it can activate the alpha 1 receptors as well as it can activate the beta 1 receptors. Even this is not a direct activation, it can release the norepinephrine by which it can activate both alpha 1 as well as beta 1 receptors. These alpha 1 receptors are mainly present on the vascular smooth muscle. So activation of these receptors results in the vasoconstriction, resulting in the increased blood pressure. As well as by activation of beta 1 receptors, it increases the rate as well as force of contraction of the heart. That's why amphetamine can produce few of the symptoms like palpitations, the awareness of heartbeat, as well as it can produce a tachycardia, increase in the heart rate. And at a toxic dose, it can also produce a myocardial fibrillation. And hypertension, a raise in the blood pressure, can also be observed with the amphetamine. What are the side effects? This drug can produce the various effects on the different types of organs. It can act on the CNS, CVS, GI tract, renal system. And in many of the organs, it can produce few of the side effects. So the important side effects include the headache, dry mouth, tachycardia, increase in the heart rate, and insomnia. Lack of sleep is one of the important side effects of this amphetamine. That's why this drug can also be used to treat the narcolepsy. A sudden bouts of sleep can be controlled by amphetamine because it acts as a CNS stimulant and it produces insomnia, lack of sleep. Anorexia, loss of appetite is one more important effect of amphetamine. That's why previously this drug can also be used as appetite suppressant. And because of this action, this drug can also produce some weight loss. And palpitations can also be observed because of activation of cardiovascular system. Restlessness, because of CNS stimulation, can produce a restlessness, tremor, skin rashes. And sometimes it can also precipitate the Stevens-Johnson syndrome, which is a fatal hypersensitive reaction. All these side effects can be observed with the amphetamine at therapeutic dose, and even at the toxic dose, it can produce a depression, psychosis, and even seizures in the patients. Drug interactions. Amphetamine shows a lot of drug interactions with many of the drugs, but all these are not clinically significant. Among them, interaction of amphetamine with MAO inhibitors is clinically significant. MAO inhibitors are going to inhibit the metabolism of the amphetamine, as well as they are also inhibiting the metabolism of the norepinephrine. Thereby, they can increase the levels of amphetamine as well as they can increase the leak of norepinephrine from the presynaptic neurons, which increase the sympathetic stimulation. In this way, MAO inhibitors can increase the activity of amphetamine, which may result in the CNS toxicity. Similarly, antihistamines can produce a sedation, as well as few other drugs like haloperidol, which is a dopamine antagonist used as an antipsychotic, can also produce a sedation. So sedative actions of these drugs are going to inhibit the CNS effects of amphetamine because amphetamine is used for treatment of narcolepsy where it produces a wakefulness, but antihistamines and haloperidol produce a sedation. So these category of drugs are going to antagonize at the pharmacological action. So when these drugs are given, the CNS effects of amphetamine are somewhat reduced. How it is given? Amphetamine is available as a tablet as well as extended release tablet. And it is also available as a suspension. and the dose of this amphetamine depends for the condition. For ADHD in the treatment of children, again the dose depends on the age of the children. So if the children with age 3 to 5 years, this drug is given at a low dose at 2.5 mg twice daily. And dose can also be increased based on the clinical conditions. And this drug should not be given for the children less than 3 years because of the CNS toxicity and cardiovascular toxicity. Similarly, for children greater than 6 years, the dose can be increased to 5 mg twice daily. Again, based on the condition, increments of the dose can also be given. Similarly, the dose for the narcolepsy again depends on the patient conditions, but the initial dose may be started from 5 to 60 mg depending on the patient conditions. So that's about the amphetamine. Amphetamine is an indirectly acting sympathomimetic. This drug acts by displacement of the norepinephrine from the storage vesicles, and for that it can enter into the presynaptic neurons through the norepinephrine transporter. And with every entry of one molecule of amphetamine, one molecule of norepinephrine is going to be leaked into the synaptic cleft, where it can act on the postsynaptic receptors to produce a sympathetic stimulation. In this way, amphetamine can produce an indirect action on the sympathetic system, resulting in the stimulation of both CNS as well as cardiovascular system. So by stimulation of CNS, it can produce a restlessness, tremors, headache, euphoria, and loss of appetite, insomnia. And even at a high dose, it can produce a psychosis, depression, and seizures. Similarly, by activation of cardiovascular system, it can produce the tachycardia, palpitations, and hypertension. And this drug can also produce euphoria, which may result in the addiction problem. That's why this drug is only used in the two conditions, for the treatment of ADHD in the children as well as in the treatment of narcolepsy. Amphetamine can be used. So that's about this amphetamine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.